क्वेश्चन नंबर
17 एंड गेटिंग डस्टेड विद इट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 17 इज डन. राइट. सो व्हेन द प्रिंसिपल इज बाउंड बाय द एक्ट्स ऑफ द सब एजेंट, व्हेन देयर इज प्रॉपर अपॉइंटमेंट. When he is not, when there is improper appointment, then the principal is not bound by the acts of the sub-agent. Question number 18 पे आते हैं. अब briefly explain the positions of sub-agent and substituted agent under the laws of agency. Till now we learnt who is a sub-agent. Now we have to learn who is a substituted agent, right? And figure out the differences in them, right? So ये भी थोड़ा detail वाला question है. We have to work a little hard on this one. This is question number 18. So, question number 18. First of all, section 190, as I told you, talks about no delegation of work can be done. Then 191 talks about who is the sub-agent. So, directly because I've already discussed this, I'll directly start with section 191. A person employed and a person employed by kya tha aage and acts under the control of the original agent in business of agency. Is termed as. अभी सीखा था भाई क्या है. Is termed as sub agent.
Sub agency
का हमने relation देखा था. The principal, the agent, and the sub agent. And when there is proper appointment, then and only then, the principal is liable for the acts of the sub agent. ये देखो हमने यहाँ बनाया था. How the tree of power looks and how the tree of control looks, and if there is proper appointment, then the principal would be liable to the third party, else the principal is not liable to the third party. Right, achhi baat. Proper appointment ke sare humne points kiye detail mein. Ab aate hain, who is this substituted agent? Right, substituted agent is discussed in section 194. राइट. सी वेयर द एजेंट, पहले लिख लेते हैं बाद में एक एग्जांपल कर लेंगे. वेयर द एजेंट होल्ड्स एक्सप्रेस और इंप्लाइड authority to name another See, where the agent holds express or implied authority to name another person to act for principal, such person is not a sub-agent. भाई सुन लो ये बड़ी ध्यान से, वो sub-agent नहीं होता है. Not a sub-agent. But an agent. Of the principal, for that part of business of agency. For that part of business of agency, ये देखो अब रिएक्ट कर रहा है. That part of business of agency entrusted to him. ठीक है, अभी एक एग्जाम्पल से समझते हैं, फिर ऊपर जाते हैं बाय डेफिनेशन में, हाउ टू लिंक द डेफिनेशन टू दिस एग्जाम्पल. एग्जाम्पल करते हैं आप एक. नाउ लेट अस से सर ऑफ बैंगलोर इज अ क्लासिक केस, बहुत बार एग्जाम में आ चुका है, तो इसको स्टार मार्क कर लीजिए. बहुत 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 इंपॉर्टेंट. राइट, वॉन्ट्स टू सेल सम ऑफ द गुड्स दैट ही हैज एट कैलकटा. सो देर इज वन लॉयर मिस्टर यश. Right. So I want to auction these goods that I have at Calcutta. Right. Now, Yash is a lawyer and he is not having any clue of auction job and stuff. Right. So Yash names someone, naming it. Right. Not appointing it. बहुत फर्क होता है इसमें. Right. But a lot of people don't consider this very seriously, right? So Yash names one person, ki bhai sir Raghavendra is a good auction person, is a person of good reputation in the business of auctioning, so you please appoint Raghavendra and he'll do the job for you. Theek hai. So, ये राघवेंद्र क्या हो गया, ये सब एजेंट नहीं हुआ है, ये हुआ है सब्स्टिट्यूटेड एजेंट. राइट, इसको हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं, को एजेंट भी बोलते हैं. वन थिंग यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड, सी आई विल टेल यू हाउ द ट्री ऑफ पावर लुक्स एंड द कंट्रोल लुक्स लाइक in sub agency and substituted agent. Bahut fark hota hai. In sub agent it is principal, then he entrusts the job to an agent. Agent further entrusts the job to a sub agent, a part of his work. Right? So, over here, this is how the tree looks like. So, the stream of power is a principal appoints agent, agent appoints sub agent. Right? So, technically, the sub agent is being delegated a part of work. Right. सब्स्टिट्यूटेड एजेंट के केस में ऐसा नहीं होता है. सब्स्टिट्यूटेड एजेंट प्रिंसिपल, देन वी हैव द ओरिजिनल एजेंट, राइट, एंड देन वी हैव द सब्स्टिट्यूटेड एजेंट और व्हाट वी कॉल द को एजेंट, राइट. तो अगर यहां देखो, no part of the original agent's work is delegated to the substituted agent. उसको नया काम ही दिया जाता है. तो मैंने यश को पूछा, भाई तू कर पाएगा ऑक्शन? यश ने बोला, नहीं सर, I won't be able to do auction. So over here, यश suggests that he has a good person and he names the person in the business of agency, right? उसी लिए हम लोग बोलते हैं यश is the original agent, whereas Raghavendra is the substituted agent. यश का पार्ट ऑफ वर्क नहीं कर रहा है वो. सो देयर इज अ मेजर डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ को एजेंट, व्हाट वी कॉल सब्स्टिट्यूटेड एजेंट, एंड अ सब एजेंट. सब एजेंट वर्क्स अंडर द अथॉरिटी ऑफ द एजेंट, वेयर इज द सब्स्टिट्यूटेड एजेंट वर्क्स अंडर द अथॉरिटी ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल डायरेक्टली, राइट. सो ओवर हियर वन थिंग दैट यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड, और एक बात बता दे रहा हूं एज वी मूव अहेड, right, the agent, the original agent is liable for the acts of the sub-agent. यहां बहुत फर्क आ जाता है यहां कि the original agent or the agent as we would call it is not liable for the acts of substituted agent. राइट, ये एक बड़ा डिफरेंस है, राइट, बिकॉज ओवर हियर द एजेंट इज द डायरेक्ट कमांडर. सी द रिलेशन बिटवीन द एजेंट एंड द सब एजेंट इज दैट ऑफ अ प्रिंसिपल एंड एन एजेंट, राइट. सो ये जो रिलेशन है, द एजेंट टू द सब एजेंट इज लाइक अ प्रिंसिपल एंड द सब एजेंट इज लाइक एन एजेंट, राइट. तो ग्रैंडफादर, right, father, son, right, that is how it works. The relation between the grandfather and the father is that of father and son, and again father and son, that is how it works. So father is the principal, the son is the agent. But when you look at agent and sub agent, agent turns into the role of the principal, wo wahan papa ban jate hain, so father ban jate hain, sub agent becomes like son. So that is how the relation works over here. And these guys are nothing but brothers, right? Yeah, father, principal, original agent, son, father, principal again, and substitute agent is also the son, right? So the family tree looks pretty very different. See, the agent is not liable for the acts of the substituted agent. Ye humne bata to diya hai, but in certain cases, the original agent may be held liable. So एक यहां सेम एग्जाम्पल में ही डाल देते हैं इसको, विल मेक द वर्क इजियर, राइट. सो इन अपॉइंटिंग और सॉरी इन नेमिंग राघवेंद्र, जस्ट राइट ओवर हियर, इन नेमिंग राघवेंद्र, यश शुड act as a person of ordinary prudence. यानी नेसेसरी केयर शुड बी टेकन व्हेन यू आर ट्राइंग टू name a person in the business of agency. Let us say Yash didn't took ordinary care. He tried to favor his friend Mr. Raghavendra, who has a track record of cheating, right? So Raghavendra over here sells the goods. He's a person not of good reputation. He sells the goods in auction and runs away with the money, right? He elopes with the money. He runs away with the money. Over here, is Yash liable, right? Because he didn't took good care in appointment. The answer is yes, the original agent can be made liable. But if Yash took good care in naming Raghavendra, and Raghavendra is a auctioneer of good repute, and still he runs away with the money. This is the first instance where Raghavendra has done such thing, and luckily it happened, or unluckily it happened with Sir, then Yash is not liable because he acted as a person of ordinary prudence in naming the substituted agent, right? So, ye ho gaya, a brief on sub-agent and substituted agent. Now, we'll do the difference between the two as required. So we have a table in place. We have sub-agent, and then we have substituted agent. Right. Now, starting with our first point, sub-agent and substituted agent, what are the differences between this? First, sub-agent is directed by the agent, right? So, who's the boss? The agent is the boss. Substituted agent is directed by the principal. Right. Principal usko direct karta hai. Now, there is no privity of contract between the sub-agent and the principal. Right, there's no privity of contract between the sub agent and the principal. Ye point thoda difficult hai samajhna, kyunki why we call there is no privity of contract? The reason is, see, there is no privity of contract between the sub agent and the principal. What do we mean by that? As we learnt in the tree, that there is principal, there is agent, and there is sub agent. Right. So technically, the agent is the one who directs the sub-agent, and the principal directly does not get in touch with the sub-agent. So over here, you understand that there is no privity of contract. So if anything wrong happens, then yeah, ek cheez likh lete hain. Phir se proper appointment or improper appointment pe ja raha hai. So the principal, the sub-agent is not liable to principal apart from cases of willful neglect or fraud, right? So if the sub agent has committed a fraud, मैंने आपको example दिया था jewelry store वाला. So let us say a salesperson or a sales department head has been appointed, and I've expressly or impliedly agreed to such authorization of appointment of the sub agent managing the selling part. Now let us say, for that matter, that sales guy cheats one of the customers. So technically I am the principal agent, let us say Mr. Yash. Sales is managed by Shanmugam. He cheats on to a customer, right, a third party. So over here, am I liable to the third party? The answer is yes, because of proper appointment of sub agent, I am liable to the third party. Is the sub agent liable to me? Yes, because of willful neglect or fraud, he is liable to me, right? But in case of improper appointment, the sub agent is liable to the agent and not the principal, right? Aari baat samajh, right? So there is no privity of contract between the sub agent and the principal. So the relation is between the sub agent and the agent where the privity of contract exists. Is there a privity of contract between the principal and the substituted agent? The answer is yes, there is. Privity of contract. Substituted agent directly works under the principal and not under the original agent. Yahan, the agent is responsible for the acts of sub agent, right? Here the agent is not responsible for the acts of the sub agent until unless in the naming of the agent he has didn't applied ordinary prudence. If the original agent was too relaxed and did not apply ordinary prudence, then the original agent would be responsible, else he would not be responsible. So in the ordinary course of things, the agent is not responsible for the acts of substituted agent. Yeah, likhi lete hain, for acts of substituted agent. And फिर से confusion हो जाएगा, सब लिखेंगे तो पूरा ही लिखते हैं. Agent, right? Now the next point is the sub agent kya karta hai bhai? Sub agent does a part of work of the agent. Some bit of agent's work is being delegated to the sub agent. Yeah, substituted agent mein no part of agent's work is delegated to the substituted agent. अरे बात समझ, right? So ये एक हो गया हमारा point important वाला, the delegation of work, right? Now the sub agent is answerable to the agent and not the principal. Here the substituted agent is answerable to the principal. The subagent looks at the agent for his remuneration. The co-agent or the substituted agent, the second name is co-agent, looks at principal for his remuneration. Right. So this is the difference between the sub-agent and the substituted agent. I'll just run through it very quickly. So the sub-agent is directed by the agent, whereas the substituted agent is directed by the principal. There is no privity of contract between sub-agent and the principal. There is privity of contract between the substituted agent and the principal. The agent is responsible for the acts of the sub-agent, whereas the agent is not responsible for the acts of substituted agent if he has followed the course of ordinary prudence and acted in good faith in naming the substituted agent in the business of agency. Now, sub-agent does a part of the work of the agent. No part of the agent's work is delegated to the substituted agent. Uska kaam alag hota hai. Sub-agent kya hai? Answerable to the agent hai. Right. Substituted agent answerable directly to the principal. Kyunki bhai hai wo log. Right. So, there is no father-son relation existing over there. And last one is, sub-agent demands his remuneration and compensation from the agent, whereas the co-agent looks at the principal for his compensation. So, ये हमारा discussion हुआ question number 18 का. Here is our question number 18. Briefly explain the positions of sub-agent and substituted agent under the law of agency. So, यहाँ हमने discuss किया what is their position and what is the difference between the two, right, in mighty detail. तो ये हो गया हमारा question number 18 समाप्त. And a surprise package now for those who think that the contract act is over. I have not taken questions of the recent attempts, so the next list is the question on recent attempts. Trust me, wouldn't take much of a time, but there are more case study based, would be really interesting to solve that, right?